Hello and welcome to Film Companion South. You're watching Not a Tolly Review. My name is Hriday Ranjan. This week's movie is Disco Raja, directed by VI Anand, starring Ravi Teja, Nabha Natesh, Payal Rajput, and Bobby Simha. In the film, we see that there is a scientist who's working on a secret scientific mission to bring a dead person back to life. Now, this scientific project has been declared illegal by the authorities, not only because it's unethical, but I suspect because it's completely illogical. We see shots of scientists working on glass panels and they are adding and subtracting different elements into the body. Now, since the entire film hinges on this aspect, it throws a monkey wrench early into the proceedings.
Hello, Dr. Shalini.
Hi, intern Santosh, what's up?
Meeru script doctor kada. Na daggara ko script undi. Kaani deeniki life ledu, doctor. Please bring some life to this script, doctor.
Actually, the heart is not in the right place. Cinema la comedians anta mandi?
Deentlo okare comedian, doctor.
Ara dozen mandini add cheyandi.
Okay, ara dozen comedians. Oh, doctor, response isthun, doctor. Inka cheppan, doctor.
Villain ekkadi nunchi?
Villain mana local Krishnanagar artist, doctor.
Ledu, Tamil Nadu nunchi teppichandi.
Oh, okay, da. Oh, doctor, it is responding, doctor. Kani deeni testosterone levels chala low unnai, doctor.
Heroines anta mandi?
Okare, doctor.
Muggur add cheyandi.
Muggur, lovely. ఎక్కడ యాడ్ చేయాలి? 1, 2, 3. ఓ మై గాడ్ డాక్టర్, ఇట్ ఈస్ రెస్పాండింగ్ డాక్టర్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్. అరే మళ్ళీ
అరే మళ్ళీ ఏమైంది? ఇదంతా కాదు, వెన్నెల కిషోర్ని తీసుకొచ్చి యాడ్ చేయండి.
ఓ లవ్లీ, వెన్నెల కిషోర్, వెన్నెల కిషోర్. ఓ లవ్లీ, లవ్లీ డాక్టర్, yes.
The film features one villain, two parallel storylines, three heroines, and yet not one convincing plotline. Like many films released recently, this film also features a part of the 80s, and because it's the 80s, it features our favorite prop, which is a bottle of Gold Spot, which makes a comeback. I think there's only one bottle of Gold Spot in Hyderabad and it's only available on film sets. The makers also from the 80s capture the spirit, the disco craze of the time, like the scene where Ravi Teja appears in a bank holding a boombox. However, much of this is superficial and the writing does not possess the glitz and the razzmatazz that is present on the film sets. Which is a shame, because technically the film seems to be giving it its all. The cinematography by Karthik Ghattamaneni is sharp. The background score by Taman seems to be suffering from a distinct Jigarthanda hangover. However, it is the editing of the film that really seems to let down the proceedings, because with such a convoluted story, you need sharp editing. But here it just seems very confusing. Thematically, the film seems to be treading a troubled thin line. Because on one hand, it's trying to be an edgy new age film, but on the other hand, it is also trying to deliver fan service. And that is where things get confusing, because you don't know what genre does the film really belong to. Is it science fiction? Is it a gangster epic? Is it revenge drama? You don't really know. Like most star vehicles, the focus of the film from the first frame to the last is on its superstar, and all the other characters have as much importance as garden lizards. Nabha Natesh appears for literally 10 minutes in the film, and within those 10 minutes, she's already dancing in the rain and has slipped into a swimming pool. Payal Rajput surprisingly manages to impress without delivering even a single line of dialogue. And as for Tanya Hope, I don't really want to crack this pun, but Tanya, nope. The one lasting feeling of the film is that you feel most of the star cast have been wasted. Talented actors like Naresh or Ramji or Satya do not get enough scope to show out their acting skills. And then there is Bobby Simha, who's generally so good in his roles, but here it's like he's completely drugged. It's like watching Poppy Simha. And finally, there is Sunil and Vennela Kishore, who keep your interest in the film intact. Now, it's amazing how Vennela Kishore stars in nearly every film week after week, but he still manages to bring in something into every film. And finally, there is Ravi Teja. Now, they say that form is temporary and class is permanent, and you see sparks of that in some of the scenes. Unfortunately, there is nobody to bounce his energy off of him. Watching Disco Raja makes you wish longingly for the days when Ravi Teja and Brahmanandam would pull off absurd plot lines with aplomb. Finally, the film is let down due to the confusing screenplay. Scenes that are not important to the plot are stretched out in the film, and really important scenes are rushed through. The comedy scenes don't seem to have ripened enough, and the science fiction scenes, what do I say, they seem like cheap knockoffs of an Avenger movie. It's like you're watching Captain Amirpet. Now, V.I. Anand has directed the film, he has also written the story, he has also done the screenplay, which in 2020 I find really baffling, because there are so many talented writers out there.
Fine.
This is a film where Ravi Teja seems to have brought his 120% onto the sets, but is terribly let down by the writing. My final verdict of the film is, if you are a fan of Ravi Teja, go watch Disco Raja. If you are not, like Disco Raja. Thank you for watching our review. For more such interesting videos, please subscribe to Film Companion South by pressing the bell icon.
Doctor, మీరు వినల్ కిషోర్ ని యాడ్ చేయమన్నారు. యాడ్ చేసిన తర్వాత కూడా చూడండి ఎలా అయిపోయిందో.
ఒక ఫైనల్ ట్విస్ట్ యాడ్ చేయండి.
ఫైనల్ ట్విస్ట్. డాక్టర్ అబ్దుల్ కలాం తర్వాత మీరే నా ఫేవరెట్ డాక్టర్.
మోనికా లెవెన్స్కి తర్వాత నువ్వే నా ఫేవరెట్ ఇంటర్న్.